Hey friends, Sam Haymart for Test Driven TV. Today on Under the Hood, we're looking at the turbocharged engine in the 2016 Kia Optima SXL Limited. This is the top of the line car and the top of the line engine for this sedan. We're going to take a complete tour under hood and show you all the technical details that make this motor special. In the 2016 Kia Optima, the company's 2-liter turbocharged direct-injected 4-cylinder engine is somewhat detuned from the previous versions, this one offering up 245 horsepower and 260 pound-feet of torque. This is down 29 horsepower from the 2015 model. Torque is only down 9 pounds of twist, but available much lower in the rev range. The key upshots here are that it now runs happier on regular unleaded fuel and gets an extra 1 to 2 mpg. In the Kia Optima, this engine's only available with a 6-speed automatic transmission. The engine has most of the modern tools to crank out the power, from variable dual overhead cam timing to direct fuel injection. The turbocharger unit itself is easy to see here with the engine cover off, mounted up top at the rear. Also seen up here is a pretty thick insulating cap that sits on top of the fuel pressure regulator for the direct injection. The insulator isn't seen with the engine cover on and is mostly there to keep fuel cool from the nearby turbocharger, in addition to sound attenuation. Airflow starts up front behind the grille and is routed to the air filter box. From there, it heads back into the turbocharger, then up and back forward through an insulated aluminum pipe. Seen here, boost is managed with a bypass valve on its way to the intercooler, but there's also an exhaust side wastegate. The Kia Optima still uses an old-school air-to-air intercooler you can see mounted next to, not in front of the radiator, just ahead of the battery. From there, air heads into the drive-by-wire throttle body and into the engine through a composite plastic intake manifold. Looking around the engine bay, this is a pretty clean installation with service items easily recognized and located. On the passenger side are the radiator cap, oil dipstick, coolant, and washer reservoirs, all in the same zone. On the driver's side up front are the air filter box, battery, and terminals, the ECU, as well as the brake master cylinder, all within easy reach and access. One of the things I think is very cool is how easy it is to remove and change the air filter. You simply snap the cover door off, flip a couple of levers, and the filter slides right out like a drawer. No scraping knuckles or pinching fingers on retainer clips buried back where you can't see them, or having to wrestle half the air box away to get to it. Very nice. So we've established that do-it-yourself servicing is a snap here. Now, while it's unlikely this car will see a big draw for the aftermarket tuners or modifications, the good news here is that the hardware is still pretty basic and old school in its design. This means changing out turbochargers, intake plumbing, and the intercooler is still a pretty straightforward thing, unlike a lot of the latest turbocharged vehicles coming to market that have integrated this and integrated that, making it very difficult to really change anything at all.
Well, folks, there you have it for the Under the Hood Tour, the 2016 Kia Optima with a turbocharged engine. Now, we've got a full test drive on this vehicle, and you can see that by clicking on the link down below in the information section. Also, click on the link right here on your screen and subscribe to our YouTube channel. We test drive one, sometimes two vehicles every week. Plus, we have a new video just like this almost every day. There's always something new, so stay tuned.